There they are, the two colonies I decided to swap. This colony should go into this nest, and this one into that one. Easy, right? I hope this ends well. Let the swap begin. Hi guys. I hope you're doing well. Welcome back to the Bruma Ants channel. As you saw in the intro, today I'm going to swap the nests of these two ant colonies of mine. These are two of my laziest colonies. One is doing extremely well, producing worker after worker without taking a break, and the other, well, not so good. The plan is this: to give the fast-growing colony more space to fill with new brood, and the struggling colony a new home to start things over, I decided to swap the two nests, hoping to create a better environment for both of them. I'm pretty confident in this plan, and I'm sure that for these colonies their best days lie ahead. But before I start with the move, let's make a quick update on the two colonies to see how they're doing. Here's the first one, my laziest Niger colony. As you can see, this colony is currently living inside a Wakushi Venus nest, a very cool test tube-based ant nest perfect for colonies in their founding stage. As you probably already know, this is one of the most kept ant species in the world, and it's considered to be one of the easiest to keep and most beginner-friendly species you can get. Most ant keepers start their journey into this amazing hobby with a colony of laziest Niger, and they definitely don't remain disappointed. This is an amazing species to start with. They are not too big and not too small, they require a lot less maintenance than other more advanced species, and if provided with the right food and temperature, they can grow extremely fast. In just a couple of years, you can go from a founding queen inside a test tube, to a massive colony of hundreds of workers. That's really fast. Especially for a beginner ant keeper. Sadly, this is not at all the case with this colony. Since I caught the queen in my backyard a long time ago, she has continued to struggle. After some time into their original test tube setup, I decided to move them into this Wakushi founding nest, hoping to see some positive changes due to the new environment. Sadly, nothing happened. Even after the move, they have continued to struggle, reducing their worker count month after month. Despite the good amount of protein and sugar I give them, the queen doesn't seem to want to lay new eggs. This is one of the reasons I decided to swap the two colonies, giving them a new and easier to manage setup. Maybe with this second move we're going to have some success. Who knows? Now to the other nest. In this one, I have my colony of Lasius emarginatus. Do you remember them? This is the colony I found in one of my flower pots some time ago. Basically, I decided to adopt this colony after I accidentally destroyed their nest when relocating some flowers I have in my backyard. Yeah, I still feel bad about it. As you can see, they're currently housed inside this very basic but effective tubs and tubes setup. Because the colony already had lots of workers, I decided to skip the test tube setup phase and go straight to the tubs and tubes, making it a lot easier to feed the colony without having a ton of ants running all over my desk. They are basically the complete opposite of my laziest Niger colony. Since I took them from the flower pots they were living in, they haven't stopped growing for a second. The queen has kept laying eggs like a Swiss clock, delivering a new batch every couple of weeks. To give them more space to fill with their future brood, I decided to move them into the Venus nest, currently inhabited by my other struggling laziest colony. The Venus has a 3 test tube configuration, 3 times the space they have in their current tubs and tubes setup. Another reason I want to change their setup is this weird and suspicious color we have in the water tank of the test tube. As you can see, the color of the water in the test tube has changed into a light blue tone, probably due to some kind of bacteria. I don't know if this is necessarily a bad thing, but to be sure not to harm this fast-growing colony, I prefer not to take risks and change the setup to prevent any type of unpleasant outcomes. But no more talk. Let's begin this move. The first thing I have to do is remove from the Venus the test tube containing the laziest Niger colony. This should be relatively easy, and hopefully will not create any particular problems. I already prepared a couple of cotton balls, ready to block the test tube they're currently inhabiting. Okay, let's do this. Ready with the cotton ball. 3, 2, 1, go. Fantastic. Now the colony is safely housed inside the test tube, which means that the Venus is ready to be cleaned. Let's start by removing the other two test tubes. To remove the acrylic top, just unscrew the lid and pull it hard until it snaps out. Just like this. For the floor piece is basically the same thing. You have to push it hard from the bottom, making it detach from the main 3D printed structure. Let's give them a little wash. One of the main advantages of having a 3D printed or acrylic nest is that they are extremely easy to clean. All the parts can be easily washed with soap water without damaging the material. Perfectly clean. So clean it seems new. The next step is preparing the two new test tube setups for the Venus, recycling the two test tubes we had in the nest before. If you're new to ant keeping and want to know how to make this kind of easy founding setup, I would suggest you check out this other video. In this tutorial, I explain in detail everything you need to know to make a perfect test tube setup. Here's the first test tube, and here's the second one. Time to reassemble the Venus. I just have to repeat the same steps I did before, but in reverse. The bottom panel, the top transparent panel, the lid, and the two new test tubes. Fantastic. Now to the moment of truth. I just have to move the test tube from this setup to the Venus nest. Let's do this. 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, I'm really bad at this. The test tube is too long for the Venus. I should have thought about it before starting the move. Instead of adding the test tube to the nest, which is definitely too long and large for the Venus, I'm going to manually move the colony to the new nest. To do this, I'm going to dump the entire content of the test tube directly into the outworld. Warning, this is definitely the worst way to move an ant colony, so try to avoid that. Okay, let's try to make it as safe as possible. Let's give the test tube some gentle taps. Great news. They have already found the two new test tubes. And they even started to place some brood there. Fantastic. Now that the move is over, let's put them away for a bit. They definitely deserve some peace. In the meantime, I can move the other colony into the old tubs and tubes setup. There they are. Let's open the test tube and place it in the tub. I'm pretty confident that with this move this colony can come back stronger than ever. Let's hope so. Look, a first courageous explorer. As a prize for the move, let's give them some food. Some dried mealworms, and some drops of their favorite sugar source, the sugar snaps. I knew it. They truly love it. Now let's feed the other colony. But first, let's see how the move is going. Wow. The queen is already inside one of the test tubes. Amazing. And look at the brood. They already recovered all of it. Ants are such efficient creatures. Let's give them some well-earned protein and sugar. Just like the other colony, some dried mealworms, and some sugar snaps. Now it's finally time to put away the two colonies, leaving them some time to recover from the stressful moves they just went through. In the end, I'm pretty happy with how the moves turn out, and I hope to make some positive updates about these colonies in the not-so-distant future. If you like these kinds of updates, don't forget to check out this other video. In this one, I make an update on my Messer barbarus colony, the redhead harvester ant. They're growing so fast. See you soon in another video.